Cuba is a country with many advantages for investing: untapped tourist environment, legal, social, and political stability. Besides, the government has openly said that wants foreign investment in order to speed up the economy, which has been in crisis for the last 25 years. That's why we are here at the Ministry of Foreign Trade to know about a law that was recently passed, which aims to seek funding for a country visually untouched.
Antonio Carricarte is the first Deputy Minister of Foreign Trade in Cuba. He graduated in economics in Hungary and has a broad understanding of what happened in the Cuban economy in recent years.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Carricarte, it's such a pleasure. I want to thank you for having us here and giving us the opportunity.
Please.
Thank you. Of getting to know a little bit about this new foreign investment law here in Cuba, which has raised a lot of questions, and people want to know a lot about this.
Well, first of all, Christina, I would like to thank Telesur for giving us the opportunity to talk about the foreign investment law, which is really very important in this moment of changes in Cuba. And also to talk about the business opportunities, which is very important for the international business community to know exactly what is happening in Cuba.
Why is this law better than the one before?
Well, I think that this law has, first of all, more advantages, and is more flexible than the previous one. For giving an example, there is tax incentives. For example, profit tax is of a level of 15% against the 13% that the previous one.
So it's split in half.
It's split in half. There is no tax on labor force. In the previous one, there was an 11% of tax. And moreover, there is a general and sectorial principles included in the law, which act as a guide for investors to coincide the investment possibility with the driver or the main driver of economic development in Cuba, and it's meaning not the waste of time and money for them, focusing their investment proposal in the priority given by the law.
And now there's also, I think, something that's probably new too, that has to do, Carricarte, with the fact that foreign investors can think in a lot of areas in which they can invest. Which areas are not inside these opportunities? I mean, they can invest in everything, or there are areas in which they can't?
Well, almost they can invest in everything, with exception in the system of education, health, and the army force. And in this sector could be allowed investment in their entrepreneur systems. But besides that, the investment possibility are in our sector of the economy.
Recently, the International Fair of Havana finished, where this new law of foreign investment was relaunched. The investment portfolio, the opportunities of business, was very detailed here by the Ministry of Foreign Trade, Rodrigo Malmierca, and it talked about 246 specific projects in which this foreign investment could be developed, and they talk about the possibility of gaining of making $9,000 million. In which calculus are these numbers based? Which are the areas in which this amount of money could be made after this new law?
Well, the amount of investment in each project has been estimated based on the viability study done by the Cuban company responsible for each project. And obviously, the total amount is the sum of all the amount of each of the projects.
Which are the areas in which you already have proposals for this?
Well, in this launched project in the fair, the main sector are the agro-industrial, the energy and mining, the industrial in various fields, tourism, transportation, and very important, the renewable energy as well.
And that means that in this kind of fields, people, I mean, foreign investors are interested in these fields, or are, you're talking about the priorities of Cuba, of the government?
We are fostering foreign investment toward this sector, but there is an increasing interest for foreign investors in all these fields.
On this, there is a very important zone, region of Cuba, which has been developed towards this opening of the economy after the updates of the economy. I'm talking about the special development zone located in Mariel, which is a port and a lot of things at the same time. Why is this zone so important, and why it has to do with this new law?
Well, within the law, we are trying to fostering the project to a special economic zone of Mariel, where we are going to concentrate infrastructure, modernizing the industrial bases, and trying to promote productive chain, not only to focus in Mariel, but also to pull the rest of the industry. And also we have a very modern terminal of container, which could help to promote the trade for importing and exporting the results of those investments.
And how, when you talk about all this, Carricarte, I wonder, how are you planning to tackle, to solve the constraints which the blockade, the North American blockade against Cuba, and has several laws which complicate very much the relations of Cuba, the economic relations with Cuba, with other countries, because it's not only the blockade, it's not only about the relations between Cuba and United States, but also with the commerce that Cuba could have with other countries. How is this law, or yourselves, solving this, tackling this kind of constraints that blockade imposed to us?
Well, the blockade is really an obstacle. Which solution depends exclusively on the United States government. But despite the blockade, there is an increasing interest by the international business community in trading and investing in Cuba. And the recent example was the International Havana Fair, where more than 600 foreign companies participated, as well as a great number of Cuban companies. And also, the business climate in Cuba is strengthening due to the process of updating our economic model. A number of general and sectorial policies have been established in correspondence with the guideline for economic and social policy. And the basis for the economic development up to the year 2000 has been recently approved. So this old instrument gives a picture or more flexible environment for business and to increase the competitiveness of our economy to fostering foreign investment.
And do you expect in any way that the blockade gets more flexible?
Well, it depends upon the United States government. But our development strategy we are considering is with the existing of the blockade. If there is any flexibility or there is a canceling of the blockade, will be a greater opportunity, not only for Cuba, but for the business international community to invest and to trade with Cuba.
Do you think that, in a way, this new law, the special development zone of Mariel, the opening of Cuba for international commerce and trade in general, could pressure, in a way, the U.S. companies to finally lobby to the government?
Well, recently we have a visit in Cuba of various congressmen, among them the president of the Chamber of Commerce of the United States. In our impression, they are well aware about the opportunity that the United States entrepreneurs are losing in Cuba. And especially, as you mentioned, the Mariel Special Development Zone establishment, as well as the new investment law, which give a great opportunity for entrepreneurs of the United States and other countries to invest and trade with Cuba. We hope that sometimes we are going to have this investment also in our country.
In Cuba, there's a lot of expectations with the results, the potential results of the law, because one of the needs that the economy has to finally raise, to speed up, it's the lack of money, the fresh money to speed up finally and to have and to see a result in the quality of life of people here in Cuba because of the loan crisis that we've been living since the 1990s. And besides that expectation, there's at the same time of this new law and with the update of the economy, there's been an opening of the private workers here in Cuba, which is called here cuenta propia, or self-employers. And a lot of people wonder why can't, according to this new law, foreign investors can put money in Cuba, but Cubans, private ones with capital enough, can't do it. Is there a perception that this could change, that this could be possible?
Well, first of all, the foreign investment law, like any other country, is to foster the flow of capital from overseas in foreign capital. And there are many instruments to do so. And for domestic investment, as you mentioned, the natural persons, a resident in Cuba, has their own domestic legislation according to which any person here could invest their money in individual activity, as you call, cuenta propismo, or work for yourself. But that's the difference between the investment law and the domestic regulation for fostering the economy in the country.
This new law, how this works for the Cuban Americans that live in the United States and have money enough to invest here, can they do it?
They can do it. We are not avoiding this kind of investment. Depends upon the regulation of the United States government.
Which prohibits that they do that?
They have prohibited because any person or company dealing with the United States markets could be fined or could be not allowed to work in the United States according to the restriction for the blockade, but has nothing to do with our regulation. The foreign investment law is open to any nationality. There is, for any extent, there is no discrimination for any nationality in the world for investing in Cuba.
Sometimes here in Cuba, the bureaucratic systems are questioned towards the capability, their capability to receive, to work in these conditions. How are you organizing the structures, for example, the ministry, the entrepreneurship community and all that, How are you organizing that so that the country could be prepared for this kind of new condition? Because this condition, with the opening of the foreign investment, would change the things here in Cuba. How are you preparing, if we talk in the administration, the managing way, how is that changing?
Well, the government also is working in modernizing the administration system, and it will help to deal with this kind of things that, of course, in previous year was a problem with delaying the evaluating and approval of projects and so on. We should work, and we are working to reduce bureaucracy. An example of this is that included in the law is the time for evaluating and approving these the projects. For some kind of project, you have 60 days during which you have to conclude the whole process. And it's a kind of instrument in order to deal with this problem.
Do you plan to expand the information access about what's Cuba doing, how's Cuba working?
Oh yes, and I think that the first thing to prove what you are telling is the launch of this portfolio of opportunity, which have been working with many organizations in the country, with many other ministries and companies which were responsible for the organization of the project, the viability studies. At the same time that the portfolio was launched in the fair, they were put in the web, and now in any part in the world, you can consider these opportunities well done, organized. But we have to work very hard, because one of the things that we think is regarding with Cuba is a lack of information, and sometimes the misinformation that the press, the international press, try to give about Cuba. We have to work very hard with it, and we're working on it.
And can we expect that, for example, some of these projects, when they're developed and settled and all that, we will be able to see the results, the information about this?
Of course, and we are going to be very open in informing about the project that have been established, because there is another manner to promote the law, given details of which company are working and which projects are being established in Mario here. I think that in the coming future, we are going to have a lot of information to share with the international business community. And we are preparing also our centers or our institution for promotion and working with the business community, such as the Chamber of Commerce, the Center for Promotion of Trade and Investment, in order to accept experience worldwide on how other countries has done in favor of promoting the investment law, the business opportunity. And we are working with other international institutions, with countries like China and other countries that has advanced in this path.
Do you think that this new law would allow the Cuban economy to finally speed up, to finally oxygen?
We are targeting to growth in the coming years for more than 5% annually. I mean, this is the level we need to really have an economic development.
And which is not happening now.
Well, we have in the last year an economic growth of about 2% average yearly, and we need to speed our economic growth over 5%, let's say for 7%, and for that reason we need to invest annually more than $2 billion. That's why the foreign investment is very important. and have a vital role to play in our economy, and in some area will be a very important place. We need to get that investment, and I think that investment, the foreign investment law, is a way to reach this amount on investment. Of course, we expect from the foreign investment not only the flow of money, but also the access of to advanced technology, to modernize also the infrastructure of the country, the general infrastructure as well as the industrial infrastructure, to modernize the management is very important. To compete in the world,
new know-hows,
to learn new how's, new managerial methods, and we think that the foreign investment law, in the way that we launch this time, will be a very important instrument for attracting foreign investment and for facilitating and to make a more flexible a business environment for foreigners and domestic companies to work together.
There's a reality, Carricarte. People, the businessmen that could come here to invest, they're looking for money. They're looking for incomes. It's good for us, for Cuba, for the country, but for them, it should be attractive. If you would advise to a community of businessmen that could be watching us right now, in which sectors will be more profitable and more useful at the same time to invest, which areas specifically would be attractive, would be interesting for the businessmen who, after all, wants to make money?
Cristina, first of all, the investment law is all kind of guarantee for the invest money here to work productively, to transfer abroad their dividend, their incomes from the investments they have done in Cuba. So for that, from this purpose, there is no any limitation, there is not any obstacle for foreign investors in investing their money in Cuba. There are several areas where we are fostering the flow of foreign capital. I mentioned during our conversation and will reiterate, the agro-industrial business is very important because Cuba is importing a large quantity of foods. In according to our estimation, half of that quantity could be domestically produced on a competitive basis. And also, if you produce more agricultural product, you need to processing, you know, to keeping, you know, to packaging, and those industries related to agro-industrial is one of the priorities given by our law. But also energy and mining. We are producing electricity, let's say, with less than 4% using renewable energy. One of the purposes stating in the law is that we need to change the energy matrix in the country. So any business regarding renewable energy will be attractive for Cuban, of course, and the foreign partners. Biotechnology is an area where Cuba has a significant advance, and we are trying to increase the production capacity for producing high technology medicines as well as generic medicines. So pharmaceutical is also a good field to invest in Cuba. And the particularly that we are seeing in this business environment is that investing in Cuba is not for the Cuban market, but also an investor. We put the money in Cuba is seeing also the regional market, because we are part of a community and we have a lot of agreement. I mean, the agreement on the basis of which we can export products from here with tax exception, import duty exception, and that could be very, very useful for foreign investors. So also in industrial, after the crisis of the 19, almost in all the industrial field, the technology have left behind. So investing in any sector of industrial, electronic, chemical, producing of fertilizer, could be of benefit, and the sense of the law is to give mutual benefit for Cuban and foreign companies.
Thank you very much. Carricarte, it's been a pleasure. Thank you.
Really, it's a pleasure for me.